Dabar Kauno Žalgirio vyriausiojo trenerio Jurijaus Dovto komentarai apie rungtynes.
Good evening. Congratulations my players for the win. Was difficult game. I expect difficult game. Lately after every league game when we play in home, we start very bad. You can remember Rita's game, Juventus game, and this game. Just that. I don't know what is the reason we have enough time to rest. We play home. I mean, we play Thursday and today is Sunday. But I expect how they practice yesterday. I expect this kind of game. But in the end, we find the, let's say, 7-8 players who was ready, concentrate, and in the end, with the good defense, we win the game.
Sveikinu savo žaidėjus. Tai buvo sunkios rungtynės, tokių rungtynių ir tikėjausi. Pastaruoju metu po Eurolygos rungtynių namuose pradedame prastai mačius. Tai buvo ir su Rytu, ir su Juventusu, taip ir šiandien. Nežinau, kokios yra to priežastys, bet šiandien to ir buvo galima tikėtis, matant vaizdą vakarykštę treniruotėje. Bet labai gerai, kad pavyko rasti 7-8 žaidėjus, kurie buvo susikoncentravę ir žaidė gerai, ir geras darbas gynyboje leido šiandien laimėti.
Hello coach, Lukas Lekavičius was missing, was he rested or has he any kind of problem?
Well, yesterday on the beginning of the practice we work warm up, he feel some small pain and the doctors, the medical staff decide to better to stay out this game, and normally we didn't want to take the risk.
Lukas Lekavičius nežaidė, nes vakar treniruotės pradžioje šiek tiek pajuto kojos skausmus ir komandos gydytojai rekomendavo nerizikuoti.
You scored 28 points in the third quarter. What changed after the break in your offense?
Wait, what do you say? In third quarter we scored 28?
Yes.
How much they score? 20, huh?
Yeah.
I mean, we play good defense, you know. In when you play good defense, sooner or later you capitalize this in offense. It's even, you remember, they score tough 3 points from Radičević. They score... Gagić scored 3 points, you know, they make some tough points. We really control them, more or less. Aurelis, no, he didn't score. And Berzis, he scored 1-3 points. This I was the most afraid, you know. They stretch the floor and they have some drivers, but we with a good defense, and we find good, especially Vanovas and Jani, they know they have great offensive day. And they score, you know, also some tough shots, especially Janis, but we find the way and the players find the way lately to communicate, especially second half. You cannot control the offense so good, you know, to punish them offensively.
Klausimas buvo, trečiame kelinėje buvo pelnyti 28 taškai, kas pasikeitė per pertrauką, kad taip tą pavyko padaryti. Taip mes pelnėme 28 taškus, jie 20, bet kai žaidi gerai gynyboje, atsiranda ir gyvybė puolime. Kalbant apie gynybą, Radičevičius įmetė sunku tritaškį, Gagičius irgi įmetė tritaškį, tačiau pavyko apsiginti nuo Reliko, kuris iš toli nepataikė, Beršinis įmetė vieną tolimą metimą, o čia ir buvo didžiausia baimė prieš rungtynes, kad nebūtų taiklių metimų iš jų, nes Lietkabelis gerai veržėsi ir skirsto kamuolius. O puolime Ulanovas ir Strelnikas turėjo tikrai geras rungtynes, įmetė ir sunkius metimus.
Regimantas Minutas had some good moments. How do you like his progress, and do you see him playing in EuroLeague more minutes?
Yeah, look, good questions. Actually, if you ask me, really positive surprise. I didn't know him. You remember we talked. I didn't know what to expect. Also, let's say, I don't want to now to, you know, he look more slow than he is, you know, he, you know what I mean? But he's very smart, you know, he use hands very good, and defensively I can trust him, you know, this is the most important. You already in, you play some minute in Barcelona after against Baskonia, and especially to, you know, now we can, because we don't have Jenki, we can put Ulanovas again on three, you know, I mean, we are back to our game, especially when they play like tonight together with TC, you know, it's also difficult for defense. But generally, to go back to your question, I'm positive surprised. He's serious, he practice hard, he come alone, and definitely I'm very happy that we have him.
Klausimas buvo, kaip esate patenkinti Regimento Mineto progresu. Tai tikrai geras klausimas, jis mane pozityviai, tai buvo pozityvus surprizas, kaip jis šiuo metu žaidžia, nes aš šio žaidėjo jau buvau minėjęs, kad nelabai pažinojau. Su jo yra toks dalykas, kad jis atrodo lėtesnis nei iš tikro yra, yra protingas, turi geras rankas ir aš galiu juo pasitikėti gynyboje, tas yra svarbiausia. Jis jau žaidė kelias minutes ir Barcelonoje, ir prieš Baskoniją, ir neturint Jankūno dabar Ulanovas gali grįžti į trečią poziciją. Pats Regimantas puikiai dirba treniruotėse, ateina pasitreniruoti papildomai ir yra geras žaidėjas.
And coach, what is the situation of Nils Giffey and Paulius Jankūnas when we will back on the court?
I talked yesterday with Jankūnas. He told me he will start running now, 14 more days. And who?
Nils Giffey.
Giffey, yeah. Nils is okay. I mean, he's here, just he must make the heart check tomorrow. And if everything is okay, he is back.
Paulius Jankūnas jau pradeda bėgioti ir turėtų grįžti per dvi savaites, o Nilsas Giffey'us jau yra su komanda, tiesiog dar turi būti atlikti papildomi tyrimai rytoj ir turėtų prisijungti prie treniruočių.
Coach, this was the best game of Janis Trenek of the season in LKL. For in a couple of last games, he didn't actually look so good, so sharp. Was there any kind maybe also of health issues he had recently? Or?
Yeah. Look, Jani, for me it's, you know, it's still maybe I'm wrong, but because I had him in Spartak, he's point guard, you know, and today he wasn't point guard. Just, it's because we miss Luki, and actually Ty was not in the rhythm. I couldn't trust him tonight, and we have Janis in Kalna, you know, and Janis today he was amazing. I mean, it was a joy to watch him, how he read the defense, how he execute, how to pass with the timing, because they change the defense all the time, you know. And it was really pleasure to have him. Normally, in EuroLeague, they know that he's maybe our key player, one of our key player, you know, and it's not easy for him. They guard him with big bodies, athletic bodies. And, you know, especially if you miss in EuroLeague the timing, reading, good screen, you know, it's very difficult to get some advantage. We know that he's not now very fast athletic guy, you know, he needs some good screens to come out of shot, or, you know, to, and this is the main difference, let's say, that tonight he was on point guard, and another thing still, that Kabelis, it's a great team, it's Euro Cup team, you know, and I was afraid of this game. We talked with your colleague before, it's a team with the nine lives, you know, they always come back, you know, they always find a way to you cannot relax, And I really respect this game like EuroLeague game. You know, I know that otherwise we can easily lose the game.
Klausimas buvo apie Janį Strelnieką, kuris šiandien sužaidė geras rungtynes, tačiau pastaruoju metu nebuvo toks ryškus. Janį pažįstu dar nuo tų laikų, kai kartu buvome Spartake. Jis ten buvo žaidėjas ir šiandien irgi žaidėjų, nes Tai Websteris nebuvo ritme, todėl ir Lukas nežaidė, todėl su Mantu Kalniečiu jie dalinosi žaidėjo poziciją. Eurolygoje kartais būna, kad jis yra vienas mūsų pagrindinių žaidėjų ir tikrai gauna didelį dėmesį gynyboje. Todėl jeigu prarandi ritmą ar būna, sakykime, bloga užtvara, tai Eurolygoje tikrai yra sunkiau atsiskleisti. Bet Lietkabelis tikrai yra gera komanda, Europos taurė komanda ir kaip mėgstu jakauti, jie turi 9 gyvybės ir visą laiką randa būdų grįžti į rungtynes, todėl šiuose rungtynėse tikrai to ir buvo galima tikėtis. Please coach your comments about the game.
Congratulations to Žalgiris team. First half we didn't control rebound at all. They score a lot of points from second chance and we didn't execute our offense. We started well, but after that we lost our deepness in offense. We started shooting, we didn't make, and that's it. Second half we tried to risk with the zone, and we didn't play smart. You know, it's always their best shooter were open, and they punish us, and that's it.
Sveikinimai Žalgiriui su pergale. Pirmoje pusėje didžiausia problema buvo net kovoti kamuoliai. Žalgiris pelnė daug taškų iš antrųjų šansų. Puolime pradėjome gerai, bet po to nepataikėme. Antroje pusėje rizikavome šiek tiek su zoninė gynyba, tačiau nebuvome protingi ir žalgiriečiai surasdavo savo geriausius metikus.
Hello, Coach. Dovydas Giedraitis played his first game after almost 2 months break. What can you say about him? How did he look in your eyes? And also his brother, Karolis, played only the last couple of minutes. Was that tactical decision?
I mean, Dovydas is ready to play now, and of course for him it's not easy to get in rhythm after 2 months, but he's the one of our main players, and I treat him like this, you know, and you must forget that he was out, and helps him get rhythm soon as possible.
Klausimas buvo apie Dovydą Giedraitį, kuris grįžo po traumas. Tai jis yra pasiruošęs, todėl ir buvo naudojamas rungtynėse. Žinoma, nėra lengva po 2 mėnesių sugrįžti aikštelę, tačiau jis yra vienas pagrindinių žaidėjų ir ateityje toks turėtų būti.
Okay, Karol, I cannot, you know, it's very tough to play with 12 players. I have 5 players today in perimeter positions. Karol has had good game against Cholet, so it's like just one game. You cannot say anything specific.
Kalbant apie Karolį Giedraitį, tai tiesiog sunku žaisti su 12 žaidėjų. Šiandien perimetre turėjau 5 žaidėjus, o prieš Šiaulius jisai sužaidė gerai.
Coach, how important that kind of a match was before, after FIBA break, was for important Euro Cup match?
Of course that, you know, I can say now that it's FIBA break, we didn't get, but it's like... So for sure, that game, I think that if we'll take that bad things, what we did, for sure that game will help us on game against Juventus the next day.
Klausimas buvo, kaip svarbu turėti tokias rungtynes po FIBA pertraukos. Žinoma, galiu sakyti, kad FIBA pertrauka turėjo įtakos, tačiau iš šių rungtynių klaidų galime pasimokyti ir pasiruošti kitoms rungtynėms.
What changed in Žalgiris game if you compare the first match in Panevėžys?
My, you know, it's not a question for me, you know. must take care about my team, and it's too much game, and I don't have time to compare Žalgiris from before and now. I have many problems with my team, I must solve that.
Klausimas buvo, kas pasikeitė Žalgirio žaidime, lyginant su pirmosiomis rungtynės Panevėžyje. Man rūpė visų pirma mano komanda ir neturėčiau gilintis, kas pasikeitė Žalgirio žaidime.
Coach, what was your first thought when you saw Radičević injured that made you run almost all the way to other side?
I was thinking that he hit with the head on that on edge on the bench, and I just react like not like coach, like normal person.
Dėl Radičevičiaus traumas, tai atrodė, kad jisai su galva atsitrenkė į suoliuką, todėl galbūt sureagavau ne kaip treneris, o kaip tiesiog susirūpinęs žmogus.